Let's go through each of these options. Let's say you had just three data values. We'd find the distance between this and this, and then we'd find the distance between this and this, and then we'd find the distance between this and this, and the distance between this one and this one, and finally the distance between this one and this one, the distance between this one and this one. So we've calculated six distances. Now imagine if we were to add another data set. Then we would calculate six more distances. The distance between this and this, this and this, and those two, and then the distance from this point to all the others. Now imagine if we had 1,000 data values, which is very typical for a data set. This one just isn't feasible. There are way too many things to calculate. Okay, so what if we found the average distance between each data value and either the max or the min? If we had four data values and we chose the min, we would only have to find three distances. Well, I guess four actually, including the min itself. But what if we had an outlier? What if we had a value all the way out here or even further? Then the distance of each from the outlier would be really far. And it wouldn't matter how closely grouped these were. One outlier would cause a huge variability. So this one doesn't work either. However, the mean is a really good reference point because it's in the middle of the data. And the mean takes every data value into account. So this is our best bet.